Money doesn't buy happiness. Fame does not buy happiness, okay? If you're in music for those reasons, you're in it for the wrong reasons, especially drumming. I'm gonna tell you a little story, a very interesting story, one that really helped me reinforce, let's say, in my mind that what I was doing was the correct thing. It's a very important story, and I think you should have a listen. So I got invited to this party one time, and it was up in the Hollywood Hills at a mansion at this guy. He was a pop star at the time. He was one of the biggest pop stars around, okay? And so I have friends in the music industry or whatever, you know. I don't hang out with the industry guys, and even less go to, like, pop star parties and stuff like that. But in L.A., you know, it was kind of happening all the time. So have you ever seen that movie, The Party, with Peter Sellers? That's how I felt at this party, okay? I said, you gotta watch that movie. It's absolutely brilliant. Peter Sellers is brilliant in this movie, okay? So anyway, we get to the place. It's a total mansion, right? A mansion, I mean, like, serious, okay? We walk into the front door, and there's this gigantic space with spiral staircases on both sides, like a movie, okay? So we walk in, and there's people everywhere, you know, one group of people here, one group of people over there, scattered. It was so big that the massive amount of people was like not that many people. Okay, so we go in there and we start looking for drinks or whatever to hang out, and we start walking around. And in every room, there was just tons of rooms just on the first floor. You know, everybody was kind of in their own little groups, so we couldn't find the kitchen, of course, and we decided to just start going up the stairs. So we go up the stairs, and it's another, like, maze of rooms, right? With people in this room, people in that room, hanging out, talking about whatever. I saw nobody that I knew, right? So we said, why don't we try to talk to this guy and see what he's about, and, you know, talk about music and whatever, just to see what he's about. So we start to look for him, since we're not interested in the, you know, people that were there or whatever. So we start looking for him. We go up another flight of stairs, again, a maze of rooms, and all Hollywood type of people, you know. Nobody was talking to us, of course, because we didn't fit. It didn't seem like we fit in at all. My buddy was another jazzer guy, and somehow he knew the manager of this guy, and they invited us to the party. Whatever. We go up yet another flight of stairs, and the house is getting smaller, so there's not that many rooms, but still the same things, like hipsters, you know, and everybody in their own little room. And no drinks to be found yet. We're still looking for drinks. We're walking around, and we're going, okay, where's this guy, you know? Where could he possibly be? So we walk up another flight of stairs, and, it was even smaller. So we finally asked some guy, hey, where is so-and-so? You know, my buddy asked. Oh, he's in there. So we finally, find out where he is. We go towards the room where he's in, and we walk in. Okay, so it's this gigantic room, right? Apparently it was his bedroom. This gigantic room with this gigantic bed. I mean, the biggest bed you've ever seen in your life. Incredibly huge, with a gigantic screen TV, a TV or whatever, movie theater kind of it was more of a theater kind of a thing. On the wall, it went from one wall to the other wall of this gigantic room, right? And so, like, wow, and we see this guy, you know, his house, first of all, his house is full of people, okay, drinking and doing whatever, just loose cannons everywhere. And he's laying in this bed, like, as if nothing was happening. Next to him was this little, short, tiny Asian girl, right, with a super tight dress on, and the pizza boxes everywhere, all over the bed. And the guy sitting there staring at the screen, right, and eating pizza, and the girl too, She was just like next to him and, you know, kind of whatever, hugging him and sitting there and whatever. And the guy's like on another planet. On another planet. His house was full of crazy people drinking and stuff. And he was just laying there. And I swear to you, I've never seen such an empty look on a person. This cat was empty inside. You could just see it. He cared about nothing. He sat there in the bed the whole time. And we, you know, debated about going to talk to him. But finally said, man, this is not happening at all. This is not interesting. Nothing productive will come out of this conversation. So we saw that and we left. We went down the stairs and we left the party completely. It was just nothing but, you know, hacks and whatever, hipsters and what, nobody there that you could possibly even have a conversation about music with, let's say. But that experience, you know, was one of the many experiences that made me realize that what I was doing was right. Okay? Money does not buy you happiness. Now, some people might disagree, and I know the whole story. Well, I can be unhappy in my Ferrari and whatever, but guess what? I know a lot of rich people. I know a lot of rich people, actors and musicians and whatever, just completely filthy rich. Not friends with them anymore. Well, you know, maybe, no, I don't have nothing in common with them anymore. And I've seen them at their worst, you know, drunk, crying, depression, misery. I mean, wow. You would think that after having all this money and all this fame and being in tons of movies and whatever, that you'd have some kind of, you know, happiness or whatever. No, just as miserable as anybody else, no matter what they've done. Okay, so the whole point of this is you should not be focusing on the end results of your career. You should be focusing on where you are right now and what you have to do. In my humble opinion, that is where the good stuff is, you know, in the daily struggle, in the, let's say, victories you have, the small victories as a musician, when you learn an exercise and you get it and you finally transcend to being able to put it in music, you know, those are the things that matter, you know, the money, the fame, all that kind of stuff. I don't think any of those people have made a connection through that. Perhaps when they're doing their art, they're happy. Well, I've known many of them that are miserable, egotistical, crazy, you know. Also, while they're on set or recording, or, you know, I've recorded with a lot of different people, and I've seen so much weirdness, you know, in the studio and on movie sets and stuff like that. You know, those type of experiences make you so grateful for being in love with drumming. So having a passion for an art form that transcends human experience, daily human experience. We've all had that feeling. When you play, you're like transported, you're out of your body and all that stuff. Not that many people can have that. So the whole point of this is be grateful for your passion for drumming, because even famous people, they don't have your passion for what you do many times. Or maybe they do and they're just happy when they're doing it, or even not even when they're doing it. Concentrate on where you are today. Don't think about the future of where you're going to do this thing or where, however. Just be happy with the progress you're making. Be happy with the acquisition of that piece of vocabulary, okay? And that's how you build a foundation. that you can use in the future. It's like you're projecting yourself into the future by being in the now and being in the moment with these beautiful things that you're accomplishing. All right, I just want to tell you that story because it was a very important event for me, seeing this guy, seeing how dead he was inside and just laying there with pizza boxes everywhere, and this little Asian girl is like bored out of her mind, and all the people in his house, and he didn't care at all, the guy, you know, it was weird. So that's my little story for today. Be grateful that you have drumming in your life. It's a beautiful thing to have in your life. Appreciate it. Be happy with that because it's amazing. All right, folks. Remember to join my lesson site if you want to learn what the pros know, which is a big difference than what the average person knows. Please check out my lesson site. Only $150 gets you into the full year program, the most innovative curriculum there is online or anywhere. Okay, peace out. Bye.